In today's video, we are going to cover some important topics about our current climate situation, as well as the answer to some questions in regard to what is global warming? What are its causes and effects? What is the greenhouse effect? What is the ozone layer, and what are the sun's radiations? Stick with us to the end to also find out how can we reduce the current alarming rate of unhealthy habits that have a negative impact on our planet. Climate change is dramatically changing the Earth's ecosystem, and the chances of us being able to effectively handle it seem slim. The only way we'll get rid of this problem is if we start taking action today. Due to the effects of global warming, it is believed that by the end of the 21st century, the Earth's temperature could increase by 2 to 5 degrees Celsius. What is global warming? Global warming is the phenomenon where the average temperature on Earth is increasing over time. The Earth's temperature has raised by an average of 1 degree Celsius over the last century, which, although it doesn't sound like a lot, has had severe effects on people and animals alike. The environment has unpredictable seasons and weather, the biodiversity is declining, and the heat on one side is melting the polar ice while on the other side is creating forest fires and unhealthy air. So, what's causing global warming? It all boils down to a phenomenon known as the greenhouse effect. Humans are responsible for this change in climate because of increased pollution from industries, leading to higher levels of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in Earth's atmosphere. Through the photosynthesis process, plants are able to live and breathe while producing oxygen, absorbing a huge amount of dioxide from the air. But sadly, many rainforests are being touched down by humans to make furniture, paper, oil mines, and habitation. As the number of trees declines, more carbon dioxide remains in the atmosphere, meaning heat is trapped, increasing the planet's temperature. One of the factors for global warming is the depletion of the ozone layer. But what is the ozone layer, and what is causing that? A thin layer of oxygen gas with three atoms in composition forms the ozone layer. This layer is about 3 to 5 millimeters in thickness and surrounds the Earth, shielding and protecting the planet from powerful radiation coming from the sun. Scientists discovered that this thin layer of gas is slowly depleting. Evidence has revealed that certain magnet chemicals are destroying the oxygen molecules, resulting in the filling of the ozone layer, which is properly known as the ozone hole. The good news is that the ozone layer can slowly heal, getting back to its original form, but only if we significantly decrease the harmful effects of the production and consumption of chemical substances. Earth's atmosphere also serves as a protective layer surrounding the planet, through which the sun's radiations do not reach the Earth's surface. Radiations can have a great damaging impact on our body, especially the upper layer of the skin, called epidermis, which protects us from many external forces. The skin damage can be repaired, but overexposure can lead to many health disorders, including skin bugs and inflammation, and can even cause skin cancer. Another very concerning topic that comes up when talking about global warming is the North Pole. 10% of the Earth is covered with ice, which is around 5.8 million square miles of our planet. If all of the ice will melt, the ocean levels will get so large that the water will partially drown all of the continents. Initially, countries located in the coastal regions would be affected by a great danger of contamination and destruction. Along with such a massive change in the seas, most aquatic and poor animals will eventually become extinct, while farming and agriculture would become almost impossible. One of the most crucial questions is, how do we prevent global warming? And how can we contribute towards saving the planet? The good news is there is still time to take the necessary measures to effectively tackle those problems. In recent times, due to protests from business environmentalists, there has been an increase in awareness about this issue. As a result, many countries and industries have agreed to collaborate on this common target of preventing global warming. There are many different aspects to take into consideration when talking about the prevention of global warming. Avoid fossil fuel extraction and usage. Invest in renewable energy through technologies like solar, wind, wave, tidal, and geothermal power. Reduce the usage of petrol, diesel, and fossil vehicles. improving farming and encouraging vegan diets. Restore nature by planting trees and protecting the forests and oceans. Reducing overall product consumption and reducing plastic usage are just a few solutions for a better future. Even small changes in our homes can have a great impact. Switching to energy-saving light bulbs, taking a walk or bicycle instead of using a car for short distances, recycling, and reducing food waste. It can be easy to feel overwhelmed thinking that climate change is too big of a problem to solve. But in reality, we already have solutions available. Now it's just a question of figuring out how to make them happen. For these solutions to work, there will need to be strong international cooperation with governments and individuals around the world. We believe that everyone can help prevent these risks while contributing to a better and healthier future for all of us. Let us know in the comments down below what you think about the current climate crisis. Do you believe in it? If yes, what are the habits that you are using to heal the planet Earth? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you find this video useful so we can inform more people about the consequences of our actions affecting everything around us.